great being here for this wonderful Howard University Relay for Life. It has such a profound meaning to me. I live in Washington, D.C., and to see young people taking up the cause to fight cancer, to save lives, diminish suffering, and the dollars they're raising goes for research, for education, advocacy, and service.
Diagnosed with neuroblastoma in 2001. It's a rare form of childhood cancer that's commonly found in children ages 4 or younger. However, in my case, I was 12. So in the medical books, I am the first child that was diagnosed at the age of 12 and also survived.
My good friend Carrie Lofton, who is a survivor of cancer, and I'm here also to support those who also are dealing with cancer and those who also survived it. So it's for a good cause, and I'm excited to relay today.
I came up with the idea to start the Relay for Life at Howard University because I lost my mom to breast cancer when I was 5 years old. So recently, I got up the courage to want to take a stand against this and do something to fight against cancer. So I talked to my lovely friends and got in contact with the American Cancer Society, and now we have Relay here.
Is it possible to do a lifetime's worth of living in just 4 short years? Then when you finally reach the pinnacle, they take you from there, because that's a life for Christopher Wallace and James Dean. The strange thing is that we all got the same dream.
I think it's really important that we have people come together for an important cause, and this is a big one, so go Relay!
I got about $700 in donations for the team. I think we're like second place so far. Hopefully we get some more by the end of the night.
You just lift your arms higher, raise them to your arms higher. Let them know you there, that you struggling, surviving, that you gon' persevere. Yeah, ain't nobody leaving, nobody.